Hey guys, Barbara here. Needing to link one slide to another? Linking is how you will do it. With hyperlinking in slides, you are able to easily link an image or word in a presentation to another section of that presentation. This means that when delivering your presentation, you can have more involvement from the audience and find out what they would like to experience next. It adds a level of interactivity to your conversation. Not only can you link one slide to another, you are also able to link images, words, and shapes to other websites. This is great to do if you're using Google Slides to create resource materials. In this video, we will also explore how to insert charts with data from your spreadsheets and how to keep this data up to date. Let's have a look. Let's start by having a look at how to link images and words to other slides in our presentations. Here, I have a presentation with all of the Open Network's mascots. I'm going to set this up so that when I click on one of the mascots, it will automatically take me to the page where it tells me more about the mascot. In order to do this, I'll start by clicking on Tobor. On the toolbar above, you will see your linking icon. When you click on it, a little window will open. If you wanted to link this image to a specific website page, all you need to do is paste the link in here, and when someone clicks on this image, they will be redirected to that site. Below this is the option to link the image to a slide in a presentation. Scroll through the slides and find the number you would like. In my case, I want it to be linked to slide number 3. When you have chosen your slide, select Apply. You will see the slide it is hyperlinked to, as well as the ability to copy the link, edit it, or remove it. Let's go into presentation mode and see how this works. I have hyperlinked all the other mascots already. From the presentation mode, let's go to learn more about Cody. When I click on Cody, notice how I am automatically taken to Cody's page. The same would go with Tobor if I were to select Tobor from the mascot slide. What we need to do now is add something to the slides that will allow us to return to the page with all of the mascots. I'll do this through a word and show you how to hyperlink words. I'll insert a text box that says Return to All Mascots and move it to the top corner. You can also do a little house to indicate returning to home should you wish to do so. I'll highlight the word return, and from the toolbar, see the linking icon again. Here, you can link to a URL or to a slide in the presentation. I'll head back to slide 2. Select Apply. If you are going to have a standard option that always takes you home, you can copy and paste this to each slide you need it to be on. No need to do the hyperlinking more than once if it will always return to the same location. When we go into presentation mode now, I can choose any mascot I want to see, and then using the little return hyperlink, I will be taken back to my choices to learn about others. The possibilities for using this tool are endless. Let's move on and learn how to insert a chart or data from a spreadsheet into this presentation. Here, I have some demo data. If I highlight and copy a series of cells from here, and then go to my presentation and paste it, a little pop-up will appear. Here you will see two options. The first gives you the option to link the slide you are about to paste to the spreadsheet. This will create a live link, and any updates that are made in the spreadsheet will be seen here. If you choose to paste it unlinked, it will simply paste in the data as static data. When you select Paste, that data will be added into your presentation. If I go back to the spreadsheet and make a change to the data range that I copied from, you will notice that back in the Google slide, an update sign appears. When you select Update, the changes that have been made will pull through. This means you do the work once and then pull it into the other areas that you may need it to be. If you would like to insert a chart from a spreadsheet, head to your menu toolbar and select Insert. You will see a number of options appear when you hover over the chart. Here, you can choose to create a new bar, column, line, or pie chart, or alternatively, to add a chart from one of your spreadsheets. When you select from Sheets, your spreadsheets will open and you can choose or search for the spreadsheet you would like to use. When you double-click on it, it will open the chart or charts that are available from that sheet. Notice the Link to Spreadsheet checkbox. Once you select the chart you would like to insert, select Import. That chart will now be added to your presentation. When you click on it, you will see the same little linking icon appear in the top right-hand corner, where you are now able to open the chart source. If any changes get made to that chart, you will see the little Update button that appears. Simply select Update and the changes will pull through.